Hi there! IntelliJ IDEA 2023.3 is out. This new version includes dozens of new features and improvements across the IDE, both big and small, all designed to enhance your coding experience. In this video, I'll cover some of the key highlights from this release. Let's take a look. Of course, the most anticipated feature in this release is AI Assistant, your AI-powered coding companion. It is out of the technical preview now and is ready to transform the way you code. The code generation AI action is now available right in the editor, which lets you insert your prompts in line with your code. You can check the suggestions and accept them or modify the prompt to get a better result. You are also able to see the suggestion in a deep viewer and decide there which parts of the code should be applied. The AI chat is also able to explain pieces of code without you having to copy and paste a bunch of code fragments. You can even ask it about possible refactoring options, or to write code documentation for you, and it knows exactly what to do. Actually, you can now do loads of cool things with it, way more than we can cover here, so we created a separate video about the AI Assistant. You can find a link to it in the description. Another big release highlight is our support for Java 21 features. IntelliJ IDEA now supports unnamed classes and instant main methods. Now it is possible to create a runnable application with no class declaration, no public and static keywords, and no string parameter. And so a basic Hello World application now looks like this, and the IDE will have no problem executing it. IntelliJ IDEA now supports sequenced collections, an update to Java's collections framework. This feature adds new interfaces to the existing hierarchy, simplifying access to the first and last elements of a collection through default methods. IntelliJ IDEA 2023.3 brings support for another JDK 21's preview feature, string templates, which improve the process of composing complex strings and applies the use of template processors. All of the other new language features delivered in the recent Java 21 release are also supported. The next noteworthy feature, which you might have already noticed in the AI Assistant screencast, is a floating toolbar appearing next to selected code fragments, providing easy access to diverse code editing actions. For example, you can quickly reformat selected code or apply refactorings. The yellow bulb with all its quick fixes along with AI actions is also readily accessible from this toolbar. Another update implemented within the editor is the inlay run-to-cursor option introduced to streamline the debugging workflow. It makes it easier to execute the application up to a specific line of code. Once your program is suspended, you can simply hover over the line of code you want to execute up to and click on the Run to Cursor pop-up. Last but not least, IntelliJ IDEA Ultimate now offers a smooth out-of-the-box Kubernetes development experience. The Kubernetes plugin is bundled with the IDE, ensuring that all features for creating, managing, deploying, and debugging with Kubernetes are easily accessible without requiring any additional configuration or setup. As mentioned, this is just a glimpse of the new features in IntelliJ IDEA 2023.3. There are many more that we've outlined on our What's New page, and I hope you are now intrigued enough to delve into additional updates. If so, follow the link in the description. Thanks for watching, and happy developing!